Hi everyone, I'm absolutely everywhere in my mind this morning. Today I've been contemplating giving up on the machine, and I also been contemplating how amazingly awesome the machine will be when I finish it. And I've been thinking about something for a very, very long time. I can very much isolate a problem into one of these five. Wilson, pay attention please. Colors. So we have mechanics, we have timing, if the music is tight, we have audio, audio quality and audio equipment, usability, that's my ability to program the machine and play music, the user interface. And then we have looks from a visual standpoint, how cool is this machine? So the Marble Machine X is made up of a combination of these five arms, and problem solving can be defined within each arm. It's really impossible for me to finish this project when I'm doing a little bit of everything at once. So what I'm trying to do is to isolate my focus, and lately I've been hyper-focused on this red arm, the mechanics. I think this chart will help me kind of compartmentalize the issues and kind of work more efficiently and turn a blind eye or a blind ear to the other arms when I'm focused on one arm. A lot of comments on this project, why don't you just only look at one arm at a time and makes it simpler than it actually is when the whole Marble Machine X actually is supposed to be in use. I'm fighting this fight, you know, between looks and mechanics, between mechanics and audio quality. It's all this eternal war between the artist and the engineer. I'm playing both sides and I'm losing on both sides, basically. While the machine is made up of all these arms, the mechanics is really the foundation for everything else. If the marbles get stuck or if they fall out of the machine, nothing else really matters, like Metallica once said. I'm going to start the machine and I want you to focus on how the tempo of the machine changes the marble behavior. Okay, we had some great examples there. So in the beginning, I deliberately didn't push these down harder. And as you could see, when the machine slowed down, the marble queue had more time to want to climb up. So here you can see the fish there is in its lowest state. So the second marble here has the tendency to want to climb like that. And what I did in the end of the test is that I just added a little more strength to these spring steel flaps, and that kind of solves that perfectly. What I am going to do is that I'm going to add extra support for the spring steel. This means that I will be able to fine-tune this complex system, and I think it will be highly reliable. But if the pipe runs empty, we have an edge case that ruins everything for us. This marble, E, the edge case marble, is coming at a high speed at exactly the wrong timing, when the fish stair step is just about to go up, which means the marble gets stuck here on the edge of the fish stair step and pushes upwards. And that's why I can't have the plastic pipe going all the way forward, because the plastic pipe will just explode in such an edge case. This is the same issue I have for all the marble gates on the whole Marble Machine X. They can never run dry. So everything seemed to go really, really well with these ones until I run into the fourth one. This one has huge attitude problems. Thank you. Our progressive springs solved part of the problem, but we're absolutely not there yet. So now we have to check if the numbers of marbles stays the same. So I made all these four channels even again. So I'm gonna run this for a long time now in a high tempo and see how long it stays even and see the general trend of the marble channels. Okay, so I have a few more tweaks to make, but first of all, I hate the word tweak. It's been my downfall so long in this project. And I want to show you an analogy here on the table of exactly what is going through my mind right now. So, okay, the artist have made a divide by four and a fish there. It's right over here, okay? The engineer knows about a way to solve this same problem over here. So this is the solution of the engineer, okay. Yeah, so far both of them work, right? Looking side by side right now, you're like, well, both works, let's take the most beautiful one, right? But what if something happened? We had an unexpected event. The engineer's solution is still holding up. And the fragile but beautiful artist's solution is now killing the whole live concert. And my hopes of ever finishing this project. When I'm doing these tweaks I'm going to do now, I'm not proud that I figured out a way to tweak or that I can actually make it perform better, because I'm at a local maximum. This solution is at a local maximum. If there's some stress into it, it goes down the drain. Whereas this solution, the robust but not so beautiful and less visually cool solution, is standing the test of time. Okay, so my analysis is that some marbles get stuck in this one. And it takes a little bit longer for the marbles to fall into this one. And that keeps the swing open and two marbles enter channel one. If you saw in the test, there was more marbles in channel one than in the others. So I'm going to make it easier for the marble to fall in here and a little bit easier here. Maybe that will help. It's like taping the markers to the table surface, okay? Sadly enough, I'm illustrating my own fragility point perfect in here, because now there's too easy to get into these two, which means that the swing flips and this one doesn't fall in. Now I have to chase an equilibrium where this one falls at the same time. Oh wait, maybe this is the perfect setup. Maybe this cleans everything up, by the way. Hold on. Maybe I struck gold here. Wait. Let's try with more marbles. Maybe I accidentally created the most fail-safe version of this ever. Because if this is stuck and the next marble pushes that one in, only that one, and then the swing flips up, this is like artificial intelligence level, okay? Okay, so these three went in. And what happens now? It works. Wait, this works. This is crazy good. Let's run the machine. This is so fun. first of all, we didn't luck out. As you can see, there's too few marbles in this channel. So I will experiment with opening it up a little bit with the Dremel. Perfect illustration of about fragile system. I took away too much from channel one with the Dremel, and now it's doing this. Huh. Okay, I'm slowing myself down a little bit and thinking. So, is there a way that I actually can tune this system? I think there is. What I'm going to do now is that I'm gonna slowly open the swing, and then we can see which marbles falls down first and last. Okay, one and two is early. There is three. Four is last. So what I want is all four marbles to escape at the exact same time. Now I'm going to take away some material from one and see where that leads us. Two goes. One goes. Ah, four went first. That's good. Three last. I'm going crazy about this. It's not going so well. I'm not giving up just right yet though. So my latest general plan is to make a self-adjusting system. I want to utilize the fact that when one channel gets full like this, I would like this device to divide more to the empty channels. I think that can work. And then we don't need the ultra stability of always hitting the right. So you see, this pipe is full and the marble queue here is stopped by this marble. So what I want to try is to remove a little bit of the metal here so this marble can escape and pass that marble like that. Then perhaps the queue can do that. So the queue moves over to the three, and this marble that comes from this full queue is already holding the swing down. So what happens in this case is that only the empty channels gets marbles. I think this is very promising. So let's start grinding away a little piece right here. I think I have fixed it. It looks like the divide by four is now self-adjusting, putting the marbles where they are needed. Let's check. It works! We are almost at complete success. We have one last test. I'm going to starve the machine on marbles so all the channels are empty most of the time. And then we're gonna test these marbles that come in the wrong timing, as I showed you earlier on the paper and pen. If this works, we're home and dry. Wow, what a day. My hands are black. I have metal shards in all the fingers. Yesterday I said that this Dremel bit was God's gift to the makers, but I must have upset God because that bit makes a kind of metal shards that goes into my skin. My whole hands is full with these super tiny sharp metal bits. I can't get them out. It's just I have to sleep and they go into my blood and into my heart. That's the plan. But this was an epic war between the artist and the engineer. And actually my analogy with the stability of the two systems actually helped me find a compromise for today. So divide by four, shh, you will live another day. The engineer saved you, okay? I could actually take inspiration in the end and make this fragile system more stable by making it self-adjusting. So basically, now I've learned so much today. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to keep track to try to make a marble count in the machine to keep this one full. Then we don't have this problem. So now I know I'm not allowed to let this run dry. Even if the machine can play for 15 minutes without this anomaly happen, that's not something I want to count on. That's a fragile system. No marble test tomorrow, the machine is not ready. Every day I think I'm giving up. That is the most responsible thing to do. I feel stupid and embarrassed for like believing in this project. I'm contemplating every day like how I'm going to communicate when I give up, and like I'm gonna say like, yeah, the naysayers were right, this is the responsible thing to do. And then every day I find something that I think I can make kind of work in a much more rigid manner like this, and I'm just going another day. I think we have a stable working system from today on, so